Hello friend, in this video lecture we will discuss application of Fourier transform. In last video lecture we have discussed application of Fourier transform. In this lecture we will discuss the Fourier sine transform. Here we solve the heat equation, we find the solution of heat equation using Fourier sine transform. See, we have the heat equation dy by u by dy by t. Suppose c square is equal to second order derivative of u with respect to x. So this is the standard equation of one dimensional heat equation. So first of all, we write the formula of Fourier sine transform for u. See here, u is a function of x and t. U is depend on x and t. So first we write the formula for u. Okay. That is the Fourier transform suffix s is operate on small u, which is function of x and t, and the resultant is denoted by capital U suffix s in bracket k comma t. Okay, in some author write the Fourier sine transform of u as a u bar. Okay, and here the x is mapped to the k in most of the book. Instead of k, lambda is there. Okay, is equal to under root 2 upon pi 0 to infinity u of x comma t sine of kx with respect to x integration. Okay, see, you can write under root 2 upon pi for both formula. If you not write here in Fourier sine transform, then when we write its inverse formula, that time you have to write the only 2 upon pi. Okay, if under root 2 pi is not here, that time you have to write 2 upon pi in a inverse formula. So remember this. Okay, its inverse formula is defined as u of xt is equal to under root 2 upon pi 0 to infinity. Put capital U here, capital U suffix s, k of t sine of kx with respect to k integration. So this is the inverse formula. Okay, now the question is, when we use the Fourier sine transform, what is the question, what is the condition for applying Fourier sine transform? Okay, if the boundary condition are u comma dy by u by dy by x tends to zero as x tends to infinity and u of x comma t is equal to zero or some function of t at x is equal to zero. Otherwise, u of zero comma t is equal to zero or f of t. Okay. For all t, that time we use Fourier sine transform. Okay. So these are the condition. If this condition appear in problem, we can use the Fourier sine transform. Okay, so what is the Fourier sine transform for the second order derivative with respect to x, with respect to t? Okay, so first of all, Fourier sine transform of dy by u by dy by t, dy by u by dy by t. See here, dy by u by dy by t. So here, this is the function of with respect to x integration. So we can write dy by u by dy by t outside the integration as a dy by dy by t. So this is what ordinary derivative. Okay. Now what is the Fourier sine transform? Here I'm direct putting the formula. Fourier sine transform of second order derivative of u with respect to x is equal to minus k square capital U suffix s in bracket k comma t plus k in bracket u 0 comma t. That is the this is the condition, okay, at x is equal to 0. Okay, remember these two formulas, which are very useful when we solve the heat equation by using the Fourier sine transform. Okay, now let us take the example on Fourier sine transform. Use Fourier transform to solve equation dava u by dava t is equal to second order derivative of u with respect to x. C square is 1 here. X is lies between 0 and infinity, that is semi infinite, and t is positive. Subject to the condition, the first condition is u of 0 t is equal to 0. Okay, t is positive. The second condition is u of x comma 0 is equal to 1 0 when x is lies between 0 and 1, otherwise 0, that is x is strictly greater than 1. This is the initial condition. Now third one is u of x t is bounded. Okay, now here, now question is which transform we should use here. See here, so here the clearly condition is given u of 0 t is equal to 0. This value, it should be a 0, otherwise f of t at x is equal to 0. So this is the first, this is the condition for sine transform. Okay, now solution. Suppose this is equation number. Okay, now I'm starting the solution from this point. This is the equation, say equation number one, and these are the condition. Okay, now u of xt be the solution of equation one. Okay, now since x is lies between 0 and infinity, and the important thing is u of 0 t is equal to 0 for all t. Okay, so from these two things we use here Fourier transform. We use here Fourier sine transform. Okay, so first of all we define the formula for Fourier sine transform. The Fourier is operate on u, the resultant is capital U suffix s, which is function of k and t, under root 2 upon pi 0 to infinity small u of x comma t sine of kx with respect to x integration, say equation number 2. Okay, now take the Fourier transform by taking Fourier sine transform of equation 1. Okay, so this is the equation 1. Here operate the Fourier sine transform, that is Fourier sine transform is operate dava u by dava t is equal to Fourier sine transform of second order derivative of u with respect to x. The Fourier, when Fourier operate on the derivative with respect to t, then we get the ordinary derivative is equal to, now the Fourier transform when operate on the second order partial derivative with respect to x, then we get k square capital U suffix s, which is function of k and t, plus k time u of 0 comma t. Now since this value is provided, since u of जीरो कॉमा टी इज इक्वल टू जीरो. तो रिमेनिंग थिंग इज हियर डीयू बाय डीटी इज इक्वल टू माइनस के स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू कैपिटल यू इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ के एंड टी. तो देर इज नो नीड ऑफ राइटिंग. तो दिस इज द फर्स्ट ऑर्डर फर्स्ट डिग्री इक्वेशन. तो वी सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशन डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन यूजिंग वेरिएबल सेपरेबल मेथड. तो सेपरेट द वेरिएबल वी गेट डी यू बाय यू सफिक्स यस इज इक्वल टू माइनस के स्क्वेर डी टी. ऑन इंटीग्रेशन देन वी गेट log of u s. See, we know that the integration f dash upon f is log of f. So here ln means log function. That is natural log is equal to the integration of t dt is t minus k square into t plus log function is exist. That's why the integration constant also log. That is ln a. Now if log is there, then convert the throat term in terms of log. Then it can be written as ln e to the power minus k square t plus ln a. Apply logarithmic property log of a plus log of b is log of a into b. B is e raised to minus k square t is equal to log of u s. Okay, taking anti-log both side, then we get a into e raised to minus k square into t. Here u suffix s is nothing but the u is a function of k and t. Say equation number, the last equation is 2. Say equation number 3. Now our next task is find the constant, integration constant. To find a, for that put t is equal to 0 in equation number 2 and 3. See the equation number 2 and 3 having the left hand side is same. Okay, now I am putting t is equal to 0 in equation number 2. Equation 2 implies u capital U suffix s k comma 0 is equal to under root 2 upon pi 0 to infinity u of x comma 0. We put t is equal to 0 sine of kx with respect to x integration. Now since the second condition, initial condition, the u of x 0 is given, that is 1 and 0. 1 when x is lies between 0 and 1, and 0 when x is greater than 1. Now we have the interval as a 0 to infinity. So divide as a 0 to 1 and 1 to infinity. In between 0 to 1, the value of u is 1. And 1 to infinity, the value of the u is 0. So see the integration 0 to infinity, we write as a 0 to 1 and plus 1 to infinity. The second term is 0. That is u suffix s k comma 0 is equal to under root 2 upon pi 0 to 1. The value of u of x 0 is 1 sine of kx with respect to x. Now the second term is 0. Okay, no problem. Now the integration of sine function. Integration of sine is minus cos of kx in denominator derivative of kx with respect to x, that is the k, limit 0 to 1. Now put x is equal to 1. Put x is equal to 1, then minus cos of k divided by k, minus lower limit and this minus sign, minus minus plus. And lower limit is 0, cos of 0, cos 0 is 1 divided by. Okay. Now denominator is 7. It can be written as 1 minus cos of k divided by k. So this is the value of u of k comma 0. See equation number. See what is the last equation? 3. See this is the 4. Now same value. T is equal to 0 put in equation 3. This is yes. K comma 0. We get A. How we get A? See, this is the equation number 3, where we put T is equal to 0, T is equal to 0, then e raised to 0. Here, e raised to 0 is 1, simply A is remaining. A is remaining. Now, the new equation is, say, 5. Now, from 4 and 5, see the left-hand side. Left-hand side is same. It implies the right-hand side also same. That is, A is equal to under root 2 upon 5, 1 minus cos of k divided by k. Now, put this value in equation number 3. See, this is the equation number 3. Here we substitute the A, that is capital U suffix S k comma t is equal to under root 2 upon pi 1 minus cos of k divided by k e to the power minus k square t. Now we want the small u, because small u is a solution of the one dimensional heat equation. But after applying the Fourier sine transform, we get the capital U. So how we get the, again, small u? So for that, use the inverse sine transform by Fourier inverse sine transform. There is small u of x comma t is equal to under root 2 upon pi 0 to infinity. Capital U suffix S sine of kx with respect to k integration. Now substitute the value here. Under root 2 upon pi 0 to infinity, the value is under root 2 pi. Under root 2 pi 1 minus cos of k divided by k e to the power minus k square into t sine of kx with respect to k integration. Now simplify, that is root 2 upon pi, root 2 upon pi, that is a simply 2 upon pi 0 to infinity 1 minus cos of k divided by k e to the power minus k square t sine of kx with respect to k integration. So we got the u. Okay, this is the solution of one dimensional equation, which is required solution of equation 1. Okay, thank you.